Okay, here's the operation today. We got the wheel harvest. Let me see, I'm trying to make this thing a little wider. It's all the way out. Wheel harvest right here, tire chains on it. Excuse me, hydrostatic. We got down here at the bottom of the swing set, we got a pulley down there, which goes all the way up to the top of the swing set with a pulley up there. Comes down to the bottom. Log splitter sitting right here. And we got the firewood stacking mama right over here.
Hi.
And there's the wood rack sitting on the forklift, you know, so you don't got to bend over. And we're dealing with some bigger logs today. I mean, these ain't the biggest, but I can't pick them up. I just thought I'd show you how we're going to do this. We set you on the tripod over here. And you can watch what's going on. You need to get the wheel harvest started. Get the log splitter started. Go ahead and start something. I'll put you over here so you can get an idea what's going on. Okay. Got to set the tripod up. Put it this way. Okay. It turned on, the switch is pointing down. It should start. Hope this one ain't gonna be too much problem today. I'll work on that one right there. Let me go back a little bit more.
It's not starting for me.
Okay. I should be able to see it all. Not even recording. Okay, we're gonna show you how I pick this piece of wood up. Well, the wheel harness picks it up. There, red oak. Now, there's no way I could pick that up and put it on that log splitter. There's no way.
Thank you.
Oregon. I'm going to go over and get this other piece of wood over here now. Right over there. Some are, that's red oak logs, and they may be dead, but they're still wet inside, and they're still very heavy. there you have it. That was four pieces of wood we got split up here. Okay, I'll show you how much we got out of it. All right. All that except for that one bottom corner piece on the right, all come out of them four logs. And then four pieces of, you know, cut off. I don't know what this stuff weighs, but it's not light. It's red, it's like I said, it's red oak, northern red oak. And get over there, Rooster. Give me a size demonstration with how big that log is. Get over there. It's got to be at least 18 inches, 20 inches across. I don't know, but that was a smaller one. This other one over here is bigger yet. But that little pulley up there with them ropes and that wheel horse, it just picks it right up, drags it right over to it. The wife's driving the wheel horse. Works pretty slick. I wish I would have thought about this last year. I broke a rib earlier, and I was scared to pick this stuff up. So I knew I was going to come up with something different. And I started building a jib on the back here, like a grill back thing. And I got my boat jack on there, you know, the trailer jack on there. On the front of there, I got that far and got the top part made for it. But I kind of gave up on it when I found this idea out. And, you know, we just let the wheel horse, it just idles, and I got a hitch in front of it, but we let it sit there and idle when we're doing this, so it's, you're not running it very fast or nothing. And nobody's working hard, and you're producing a lot of firewood. We already got one, that rack over there, right behind the wheel horse over there, back over there. We already did that one, cut and split. There's two rows in that stack, and we already did that one today, and we're starting on this second one over here today. But yeah, hey, you need to pick up some of the bigger ones. They yield a lot of firewood, you know. I mean, it's just a pain in the neck deal with the things, and this here is one way to help, you know, help deal with it. These ain't the biggest logs, but they're more than I can pick up. So, hopes I can help somebody out later.